1, we're going to evaluate the following trigonometric expressions. And basically, this one has the form, since my angles are the same, we just have sine squared of angle plus cosine squared of theta, and that's going to equal 1. So those are the same. That means that equals 1 as well. All right, for the second one here, we have 2, and tan of 300 is going to be x over y, y over x. And basically what you want to do with tan is, if you know that there, it's either going to be square root of 3 over 3 or square root of 3. Since we know this is y over x, and that our y is the longer side of the triangle, we have square root of 3 over 2 divided by 1/2. So that's just going to be square root of 3. And then the square really goes on the outside. Plus 3, and then we have sine of 150. And sine of 150, that's the shorter side. That's, and this is supposed to be negative 2. So that's going to be negative, this is going to be positive 1/2. Because this is in quadrant 2. Minus cosine of 180 is negative 1. And then you square it. So basically what you're going to get is 2. When you square negative square root of 3, you get just 3. Plus 3/2. Minus 1. So this is 6 minus 1 is 5, plus 3/2, which is going to be 10 over 2, plus 3/2, which equals 13 over 2. All right, and the next one is this one. We have cotan of 135. So I'm looking at my unit circle at 135. We know that's a 145. And cotan is x over y, so that's just going to be negative 1 minus sine of 210, and that's going to be minus, that's a negative 1/2, plus 5, this is supposed to be squared, so this is squared. Let me see if this one's squared. No, this one's not squared. All right, 5 times cosine of 225. Cosine of 225 is going to be negative square root of 2 over 2. So we have 1 plus 1/2 minus 5 square root of 2 over 2. And 1 plus 1/2 is 3/2. So you get 3/2 minus 5 square root of 2 over 2. Or you can write this as 1/2. Times 3, whoops, doesn't look good. 1/2 times 3 minus 5 square root of 2. Now, on this one, you could just look on your circle and go down clockwise 30 degrees in cotan. And cotan is x over y. X is your longer part, so this is just going to be square root of 3 over 2, which is negative, because we're in quadrant 4. And then tan of 600, if you subtract 360, so 600 minus 360 is going to be 240. So tan of 240 is going to be y over x, and y is the longer side. So why did I put 2 here? That's just square root of 3. All right, tan of 240 is y over x, which is just going to be square root of 3 minus, and if we get cosecant's even function, so I can pull this negative out and make that a positive, but it still doesn't help me. So if you subtract 360 from that, you get 90. So we want cosecant of 90. And cosecant of 90, cosecant's 1 over y, so that's just going to be 1. So our final answer is negative 1. So you're just filling it in and looking at your circle, or you might have it memorized. Okay, this one we have cosine of 2 pi over 3. 2 pi over 3 is in quadrant 2, and cosine is your x. X is negative, and x is going to be the shorter side, so that's going to be negative 1 half minus, and tan of 3 pi over 4 is negative 1. And then you square that. So basically you get negative 1 half plus 1 squared, which is 1 half squared, which equals 1 fourth. Now on this one, we have this a minus b times a plus b. So basically what this is going to be a squared minus b squared. So basically we have sine squared of 11 pi over 6 minus tan squared of 5 pi over 6. So that makes it a little easier if you do that. So 11 pi over 6, we need sine. Sine is your y, and y is your shorter end, and it's negative. So this is negative 1 half squared. I'm looking at the triangle when I'm saying the short end. So when I'm saying this, I know that this is the shorter side is 1 half. The longer side is square root of 3 over 2. All right. 5 pi over 6 is your 150. And that's going to be tan is y over x. And we know our y is going to be the 1 half part. So that's really 1 half over square root of 3 over 2. So that one you should know is that's just 1 over square root of 3. And since it's negative, we'll put the negative there. But that's going to be negative 1 over square root of 3 squared. So this is going to be 1 fourth minus 1 ninth. And common denominator is 36. So that just be 9 minus 4. So that equals 5 divided by 36. And that's it. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.